hang there. Thank you.
Congratulations on your recording contract. The last time you were in this studio, this very studio, you were in Pop Idol trying to get in to the last 10, and now you're trying to get into the top 10.
It's very strange, yes. I did a double take when I sort of walked in earlier on. But, yeah, it's really nice to be here.
And you're going to do the single for us later on?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. Yeah.
Now, I believe you've had a bit of a change of lyrics on this latest single. What was that all about?
Well, they said that, obviously, for kids' TV, I think the lyrics would probably have been a bit too saucy or what have you.
A bit cheeky, were they?
Bit cheeky. But, yeah, so we had to tone them down a little bit. But that's fine with me because it's obviously understandable.
Did you write the lyrics, Rosie?
I didn't, actually. No. I had to listen and I thought to myself, you know, if we'd have just chucked them in for no reason, then I wouldn't have perhaps gone with it. But I thought, you know, it's got a nice aura, so...
It's all happening, though, isn't it? I mean, there you are working in a checkout.
I know.
In a supermarket, seeing pop stars and hearing them... And suddenly, you'd be dreaming of it one moment, fame, and here you are becoming famous. Is it a disappointment or is it, you know, like what you thought it might be?
I still have to pinch myself. Quite often, I sit there and I'm like, ooh, am I really doing this? But it's not a disappointment. I knew it's hard work, but I knew it was going to be hard work. And I don't mind that because I just love getting up and doing this every day, you know, and that just keeps you going.
Better than working, isn't it?
Oh, God. I mean, you must get recognised a lot. And I would imagine, I mean, do you think that the boys may be a bit scared of you now? Are you kind of unapproachable now that you're famous?
I don't know. I don't really go out enough, really, to get approached. But, yeah, I mean, I'm not really sure sort of what they think, but I think when I have been out a couple of times, people just tend to sort of leave me alone sort of thing, you know, but sort of look, but...
And you share a flat with Hayley, isn't it?
She was here, Hayley.
Yeah, she came on the show. Yeah. And do you kind of vet each other's boyfriends or do you, like, give each other advice about fashion and all that?
Yeah, I mean,
girly
stuff. Yeah, it is really nice because, you know, we'll sit there with our cups of coffee and, you know, we'll have Eastie's on the telly or something, you know, and we'll just sit there and chat about girly stuff.
Yes.
As you do, you know. So, yeah, it's really nice. And especially that we've got so much in common as well, you know, doing the show, you know, that we can really share that with each other. So that's nice as well.
Do you, I mean, two girls, it's like a sitcom, isn't it? Two pop girls, one, you know, she's doing great, the other one's doing good too. And do you, I mean, she's on telly now as well, doing the...
She's doing the Rivals,
yeah. Do you, I mean, do you actually do the ordinary things? Or have you got the cleaning ladies left? I mean, are you cooking and... Who's doing what?
Actually, it's really quite funny because we are just so normal, you know, I mean, we just sort of, we just sit there, you know, and hang out. Hayley does the cooking because I'm absolutely
Any good,
rubbish.
Is she?
She's not the best, but she's
What's
a lot better than me.
What's her forte? What does she like to do?
She always cooks spaghetti bolognese, which is great for me. I love that. and I think I'm just the messy one, really. I just sort of...
and she's what's your nickname, Spick, for? That's not, it's obviously not Spick and Span, is it? That's for
no,
sure.
I mean, it's it's quite funny, actually, because one of my best mates back in Wales... it's quite a long story, but I'll cut it short. She was eventually called Span, because her name's Carrie Ann, and we just called her Carrie Spanner, and then it was Span. And it was really strange, because one day we just decided that it would be quite funny just to be Spick and Span, so... Mm-hmm.
So you're Spick?
So I'm Spick and she's Span.
And you're an Australian, aren't you? How were you born there?
Yeah, I was born in Australia. I lived there until I was 5, and then we moved to Wales, so... Yeah.
Oh, I love Australia. You've been to Australia?
I haven't. You've been there a lot, haven't you?
I love it. See, they're mad on sport, aren't they?
Oh, my mother, she's... I tell you... That's all she's got on his sports channels. Rugby, cricket, anything. She'll have it on.
Yeah, I just love it. I remember when they knew I'd been into horse racing a bit, and I had this horse, and I went down there, and they said they had a jockey called Kevin Moses. I don't know whether you remember him. He was a top jockey down there.
Yeah, yeah.
And they said to me, bring your horse down, Des, and we'll let Moses ride it. And I said, Jesus couldn't win on this. That went all around Australia.
Sorry.
Choreographed talk. After you.
Do you remember Australia? Because you were only 4 when you... Do you remember being there?
Yeah, I do, actually. It's quite surprising. I do remember quite a lot. I think it's because it was such a big change, if you know what I mean. So it's sort of set in my head.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I do remember, you know, quite a lot about it.
Is it true you had a pet kangaroo? Or was that silly?
No, actually, yeah. I mean,
a pet kangaroo?
We used to sort of live in the outback, sort of in a, in a little town in the outback. And we had the only shop for miles.
Tell me the kangaroo was called Skippy.
No, it wasn't.
Well, it's lovely having you here, really. Look, we haven't used this lately. We started some of the beginning of the series, and somehow we seem to have stopped.
These
are fortune cookies. You can pick anyone. You just it's just a little silly question in there.
Can you eat these after?
You can eat them if you want to.
If you're hungry.
Yes, they're quite edible.
Right, and
just break it open.
And then read it for us. And none of those are fixed, so, you know. Well, no, really not. Change it if you want to.
Right, it says, Where was the worst place you ever visited and why?
Yeah, where was the worst place?
Where was the worst place I ever visited? Ooh.
Well, send us an email. Everybody else sends us emails.
Where?
I'm not sure, actually.
Don't worry
but it was quite funny because when I went to do the video, everybody expected to be in all these really glamorous places and everything. And it was really funny because we ended up in a place called Perivale.
Where?
And it was in a massive industrial estate, and everybody thinks, oh, you know, it's all glamorous and everything. And there was all sort of there was this cafe with like a big Elvis statue just up the road. It was really bizarre, but yeah, that was pretty strange.
I've been to stranger places over the years. We won't get into that. What's the new single called?
It's called Blink.
Blink.
Blink. Blink.
Well, we won't do that while you're on. After the break, you're going to be doing that for us, okay, Kiddo?
Yeah.
We thank Rosie Ribbons. See you in a couple of minutes.
Thank you.